Welcome friends to One Stop Java Solutions. I am Snehasis and today I am going to explain you TCS proctored assessment of 19th June. Okay, so here is the assessment. So first read the assessment carefully and try to understand what you have to do. Okay, then we will implement or solve this assessment. Okay, so first you can see that create a class autonomous car. So you have to create one autonomous car with the below attributes, then getters, setters of the above attributes, okay, and create the constructor which takes parameter in the above sequence, means in this sequence only, and above sequence except grade. Okay, so constructor grade should not be included in the constructor. So in means exclude grade and include these 1 2 3 4 5, these 5 parameters. Okay, then implement two static method, find test passed by environment and the update create grid in solution class. Okay, so in solution class. Okay, so solution is the main method, should contain the solution class. Okay, so first implement this part. So I'm going to Eclipse. Okay, so here you can see I already have YouTube demo. Okay, then here I am creating one package. New create package and give the package name like TCS. The package name should start with small letter, proctored assessment. This is 19th June. Okay, so I am creating this package. Click on finish and then inside this package create the class solution. Create class and you can copy the class name solution from here and paste here. Okay, so this is your solution class. So click on finish. Okay, and you have to write the main method inside this class. Okay, so here just writing public static void main string args. Okay, so this is your main method and in this class you have to write other two static method. Okay, these two static method, find test by environment, find test passed by environment and update car grade. Okay, these two, and create another class autonomous car. So first create that one. So outside this class create another class. So this class is public because we have saved the this file as a solution.java. So you know that the whatever the public class, you have to store that class with the same, means in the file.java file name should be the same as the name of public class. Okay, so another class what I am writing, autonomous car. I am just writing class. You cannot create it also public. Okay, now it's autonomous car and here you have to write this attribute. Okay, so I am writing this attribute. Okay, then you have to write the setter and getter method. So best practice, you can do the this as a private. Okay, private means always data member should be private. So just write all the data members, make them private so that you cannot directly access this variable outside of this class. You have to either use setter and getter method to access outside of the class. So I am writing setter and getter. So for that, right click on ID and here you can see source is there. So go to source and then generate getter and setters. Okay, and select all the attribute and click on OK. Okay, so setter and getter method will constructed here. Then go to source again and create the constructor. Okay, generate constructor using field and here you can see you have to exclude the grade. Okay, rest of these should be there, car ID brand, these 5 should be there, but grade should not be included in the constructor. So click on this, the constructor will also create it. So this is the autonomous car class. Okay, so this is done. So solution method implement. Okay, so getter and setter method above attribute, create constructor with take parameters in the above sequence except grade. Okay, and create a class solution with the main method, that also done. Implement two static method. Okay, so now you have to do this part. Okay, so for that you have to write, you have to go, okay, so go to this class solution and here write public static and method name is this and return type. So then you have to mention the return type. What is the return type? So if you read it, find test passed by environment method. So this method will take two input parameters, array of autonomous car. Okay, so it will take autonomous car array. Okay, so I am giving AC and then autonomous car array of autonomous car object and string parameter environment. Okay, so it will take string environment, string environment. Okay, and what would be the return type? This method will return the sum of the number of tests passed. Okay, so some integer. So here just write int, return type should be int. Okay, and you have to return the values from here. So here you can see that array autonomous parameter environment, the method will return the sum of the number of tests passed. Okay, so sum. So here I am taking one integer int sum equal to 0 initially, and I am returning here return sum. Okay, then after that I will means implement this method. Okay, so as of now I am doing this. Then the next method autonomous car. Okay, and here you can see that the attribute from the autonomous car object for the environment passed as a parameter. So the method will return the sum of the number of tests passed attribute from the autonomous car object for the environment passed as a parameter. If no autonomous car with the given environment is present in the array, then autonomous car object, then the method should return 0. Okay, so that's why I initially assigned it, the value is 0. Okay, initial value is 0 and then I will check. So okay, I'll implement this later. Then find test by, so this is the done. Then you have to write this, so update car grade. Okay, so right, same way public static, public static, then this is your method, and what it will take, this method will take string parameter brand along with the array of autonomous car object. Okay, so this is the autonomous car array, so this will take, and next parameter is string brand. Okay, so string brand, and then object and method will return the autonomous car object, one autonomous car object. Okay, so inside this it will return autonomous car object. So for that write autonomous car, and you have to return this autonomous car object. So for that here first I am creating one autonomous car, autonomous car, sorry, A should be capital, autonomous car, this is the class of So here autonomous car, I am giving the name AC object. AC object, and initially I am assigning null, because here you can see that the methods derived based on the rating calculation method below, this grade value should be assigned to the object. If any of the above condition is not met, then the method should return null. So initially I am giving the null and returning this autonomous car object, AC object. So return AC object from this method, and its value is null. TURN. Return AC object. Okay, so this is done, and then you have to implement this one as well. Okay, and after that, if you see here, so you have to call these two method from the main method. Okay, from main method you have to call, then find test, this method should print the total number. In the main method you have to write this, and before calling here you can see, before calling those static method in main, use the scanner object to read the values from the autonomous car object referring attribute in the above mentioned attribute sequence except grade attribute. Next, read the values of environment parent. Okay, so four autonomous car object you have to create. Okay, so in the main method I am creating four autonomous car object. So for that you have to take input from console. So first I am writing scanner. Scanner sc equal to new scanner and system dot int. Okay, so using scanner class I am taking all the input. Okay, so you have six attributes. So among six you have to take five attribute for each object. Okay, because grade, last one is the grade, so grade you have to calculate, and rest you have to take. So for using scanner you have to import the java.util.package. So it is in java.util package, so java.util.scanner you have to import. Okay, so scanner is equal to new scanner, then I am iterating on for loop. So for int I equal to 0, okay, I less than 4, you have to create 4 autonomous car object. So I less than 4, I plus plus. Okay, and inside that I will take the input from console and create the object and store in a autonomous car array. So here autonomous car AC I am creating here, autonomous car AC equal to new autonomous car and giving the size 4, mentioning size here 4. Okay, and in each iteration you have to read these values. Okay, so I am copying, giving the same name, so that's why I am copying from here, except grade, copy the rest 5. Okay, so grade you have to calculate. Here I am pasting. So car ID equal to, so here not private, it's int, remove this private. Okay, and int car ID equal to sc dot, so this is the integer type, so next int, sc dot next int. Okay, so car ID equal to sc dot next int, then string brand, so this should be sc dot next line. For string you have to use the next line method. Okay, next line. And for number of test conducted, this is int, so sc dot next int. Okay, semicolon here, then it's int, so for that also use the sc dot next int. Okay, sc dot next int, and string, it's environment string type, so sc dot next line. Okay, so like this way you can take the values from console. Okay, and once you have created, then you have to create a object and store in this autonomous car array. So ACI equal to new, then this autonomous, you have to store the, in each iteration you have to create one of array with this value and you have to store. Okay, so ACI equal to new, then you have to call this constructor. Okay, so for that I am copying here. Okay, copy this constructor signature and pasting here. Okay, and remove this variable, remove. So I am, because I give the same name, so you can copy from there instead of writing this. So it should be called in like this order also of the parameters. Okay, so I am creating construct, I am calling this constructor with the car ID, brand, number of test conducted, number of test passed and environment. Okay, I am calling this constructor and creating one object and storing this object into the autonomous car array. Okay, so like this way, so this loop will iterate 4 times. Okay, so 4 objects will be created and it will be stored in the autonomous car array. Okay, then in the next, read values from environment and mention the attribute in sequence except the grade attributes. It's done. Then next, read the values from environment and brand. Okay, so outside of this loop you have to track once again the environment value. You have to read environment value because you have to pass this environment. Okay, so outside this for loop, string is equal to ac.next and brand. Okay, so brand, this is the brand. So these are the local variable inside this for loop. So outside you can, you have to again declare it. So string environment equal to ac.next line and string brand equal to ac.next line. Okay, once you read, then you have to call those method. Okay, these two method. So before calling, here you can see, before calling this static method, main will do perform this task. So this is done. Then you have to call this method. Okay, and this method, here you can see, here you can see that this method will perform if the string parameter matched with the brand attribute of the autonomous car object. Okay, then you have to, okay, so first I am implementing this one. Okay, the method will return the sum of the number of test attribute from the autonomous car object for the environment passed as a parameter. So if whatever environment you are passing and whatever environment inside this autonomous car object, if these two are matched, then you have to perform, means add the sum. Okay, you have to calculate the sum. So for that, what I will do, so int sum equal to 0, and here also I am writing one for loop for int I equal to 0, I less than 4, and I plus plus. You have to iterate 4 times because your array size is 4. And in each iteration, what I will check? I will check if ACI dot get environment. Okay, if ACI dot get environment dot equals whatever environment you are passing. Okay, this environment. Okay, if these two are equals, then I will calculate the sum. Then sum equal to sum plus, sum equal to whatever sum value is there, initially it's 0, then you have to calculate number of test passed. Okay, sum of the number of test passed. So number of test passed, So for that you have to call ACI dot get number of test passed. Okay, so if this match, then we will sum number of test passed. Okay, and after that we will return the sum. So this is the simple logic. Okay, so sum. And now once we have to call this method for main method. Okay, and if main method will check, here you can see main method should print the total test passed, and for find test passed by environment method, the main method should print the total test passed as it is if the return value greater than 0, or should print there no test passed in the particular environment. Okay, so we will have to call this method find test passed by environment for main method. So int x equal to find test by environment, and we are providing AC because we are stored adding these AC values, AC and environment. Okay, so using these two parameters we are calling find test passed by environment, and after that we will check if x greater than 0, then we will print this value of x, because this is the sum of the number of test passed. Okay, if it is not greater than equal to 0, it means 0, then we will write else we will print this message. Okay, there are no, this is the message. Okay, so we will print this message, there are no test passed in this particular environment. Okay, and next you have to call the next method. Next method is update this one. Okay, so next you have to call this method, and you have to store in a autonomous car object whatever value it will return. So we'll call with AC and brand. Okay, AC and brand, and here autonomous car AC object equal to update grade car. So I am storing in a autonomous car reference, no object reference. So whatever it will return, I will store in this AC object. I am giving the same name. So AC object, and then you have to check here. Okay, so before that you have to go there and implement this method. So before returning the object, the grade should be derived based on the rating calculation mentioned below. Okay, so you have to first calculate the rating, and before that you have to check the mentioned will return autonomous car if the input string parameter matches with the brand attribute. Okay, so we are calling with AC and brand. Okay, so here also you have to write a for loop. So I'm copying here and iterating 4 times, because inside in this array you have 4 values. Okay, and every iteration will check if ACI dot get brand dot equals whatever brand we are passing dot equals brand. Okay, dot equals brand, because whatever brand we are passing, if the array of autonomous car is contain the same brand, then what we will do, then we will calculate this. The grade attribute should be calculated as follows. Okay, this is the rating. Okay, and if rating is greater than 0, so you have to take one variable int rating equal to, and you have to perform number of test passed *100 by number of test conducted. Okay, so this is the logic. So writing, and number of test passed, basically this is how we will get. So AC dot get number of test passed, so you have to call this AC dot get. Okay, just write get number of test passed. Okay, number of test passed, this method, remove *100, then number of ACI dot get number of test conducted. Okay, so like this way you have to calculate the rating. And okay, this method should not be there. Okay, and here you can give one bracket, remove it, no issues, or you can give it as well. Okay, so this is done. Then this is your rating, and then you have to check this part. If rating greater than equal to 100, okay, then grade should be A1, else grade should be B2. Okay, so here you have to means check if rating greater than equal to 80. Okay, if rating greater than equal to 80, then grade should be A1. Okay, so if this, then ACI dot set, you have to set the grade value, set grade. Okay, and pass the values at A1. Okay, and else same thing, ACI dot grade, and you have to pass A2. Okay, so you have to pass A2. Here you can see it's, sorry, B2, A1 and B2. So you have to write it B2. And if this is done, so then what you have to do, that AC object, because this should match only one. So this is the criteria that there should be, means no repetitive brand. Okay, so only one brand would be matched. So AC object, you have to store AC object equal to ACI. Okay, so whatever is the current object, so you have to store in this reference. Okay, AC object, autonomous car reference, and then you will break. So it will break from this loop. So once it matched, it will perform this task and it will break from here. Okay, so this is done, and if it's matched, then it will send this object, means ACI object. Okay, and if not matched with any values, then it will return null, because initial value of the AC object is null. Okay, so now inside this method, main method, so we have called this, and now you have to check if AC object equal to null, then we will print, remove this line, this bracket you can remove, because only one line you have to print. So you can print that message. The message is written here. Called for main method. Okay, there are no test passed. No card is available in the specific brand. So this is the message. Copy. So you have to just paste here. No card available brand. Okay. And else you have to print. Else you have to print. Sorry, println system.out. System.out.println, and you have to write print the message like this way. Car object, the brand and grade should be concatenated with this while printing, like Tesla colon A1. Okay, so method will print the brand and grade. Okay, so if brand and grade, so for that you have to write AC object. OPJ dot brand get brand. Okay, then give plus and double colon and then plus brand and then grade. Okay, brand and grade. Then you have to run op AC object dot get brand and grade. Okay, so this we have to print. Okay, so this is the implementation. So now here you can see this is the input set. Okay, input set. So this is the ID, this is the Tesla, means this is the second parameter. What was that? This is the second parameter, means brand. Then number of test conducted. Okay, 1000. Number of test pass is 500, and the last one is the environment. Environment is hills. Okay, and like this way we have giving the input parameter. So if you give this input, so first copy this input and store in a notepad. Okay, so this is your input, and last two here you can see there is a 20 up to this. There is a 20, means you have to every object will store 5 attribute, means contain 5 attributes. So you have to create 4 objects, so that means 20 values. And last two, desert and Mercedes, these are this environment, the last two part, these two means environment and brand, whatever environment you are, and this is the brand. Okay, so last two values is for the environment and brand. Okay, that you are passing. Okay, so copy the whole thing. Okay, and if you execute this code and keep this, okay, here it's giving some exception, main java.util input, okay, mismatch exception, input mismatch exception, solution.java 15. So go to this line and check what is this. This is the int. Okay, so here it is a problem that after getting any string value, means here we are expecting a string values and then we are taking the int value. So after taking any int value, if you try to get any string values, then here you have to use an sc dot next line. Okay, you have to use one sc dot next line blank. And also here you can see after int values, this is also int value sc dot next line. Okay, so this is a string value, so here also you have to use this. Okay, so once you take input as integer, and after that if you means take any string values, then you have to use one sc dot next line. Okay, so again rerun it. Okay, and copy the values and paste it. Okay, so here you can see output is the 19,000 and Mercedes is B2. Okay, so if you see the output values here, it is 19,000 and mass at each bench. Okay, so what we are passing here, desert. Okay, so desert is your environment and Mercedes is your brand. So here if you see from the input set, so where it is desert, okay, here it is desert. Okay, so this is one desert. Okay, so it's calculating for the desert is 19,000 and for Mercedes we are passing the Mercedes. So if you see the first method, okay, so first method, what it is doing, first method is checking if the get environment dot equals to environment. So what environment you are providing? Desert. Okay, so here it is desert, and if it is equal to the environment, then sum equal to sum plus get number of test passed. So number of test passed, here you can see number of test passed is 1500 and here is 400, so it is 1900. So that is the output result, 1900. And in the second method, it is printing Mercedes B2. So why it is printing Mercedes B2? So here what we are checking, that the brand, okay, equals to this brand. So we are passing brand as Mercedes. So here only this one is Mercedes. Okay, so this value is Mercedes. So Mercedes 1400 desert. So we have to calculate this rating first. So rating equal to ACI dot get number of test passed into 100 divided by number of test conducted. So number of test passed is 400 into 100, that means 40,000. Okay, divided by number of test conducted. Number of test conducted is 1000. So that means 40. Okay, so 40 is less than 80. Okay, so grade is B2. Okay. So if grade is B2, so it will print the brand, that is Mercedes, and the grade B2. Okay, so expected result is Mercedes B2. Okay, so in this way it will checking. So if you change the out input, means this input, so this is a desert. Okay, this is fine. So if you, instead of desert, if you write something XYZ. Okay, and instead of Mercedes, if you write, suppose Audi is not here. So if you run this, so if you execute it once again and run with this set of values, then you can see there is no test passed in the particular environment. Okay, because this is whatever environment you are passing, that is not matching with the input set. And no car is available with the specified brand. Audi is not included in the input set. So that's it. It's giving the zero message. Okay. So that's it. So I'm explaining the code once again. So first what we did, first we create this method. Okay. Autonomous car with these attribute. Okay. And we write the setter getter method. Okay. Here. And also we write the constructor, parameter is constructor. Okay, and then we create the main method. Okay, and inside the main method we read the values of those attribute from the console using scanner class and create four autonomous car object. Okay, so here we have create the autonomous car object and stored in ACL. Then we take the values of environment and brand, and we are passing, calling the find test method with this array of autonomous car object and this environment. Okay, and then we are printing the appropriate message, whatever it will value it's return. Okay, and for next one also we are calling with the array of autonomous car object and brand, and we are printing the appropriate message, whatever it is returned. And these two method, what is doing, these two method is calculating. In the first method we are checking if any values inside the array is containing that environment, then we will perform this part. Okay, perform this part, and we will calculate the number of tests passed. Okay, and return that value. And in the second method, we are checking, we are providing the brand. So we are checking if any value, okay, including this array, is containing this brand, then we will performing this part. So first we will calculate the rating, and rating formula is this: number of tests passed *100 by number of tests conducted. Okay, rating. And if rating is greater than 80, then the grade would be A1 and it will be grade would be B2. And here grade means every autonomous car object will contain a grade value, but that grade value we are not supposed to provide manually. Okay, we have to calculate this rating, and based on the rating we are set the values of grade. Okay, so that's why we are calling set grade from here. Okay, and set grade, and then it's returning this method will return the autonomous car object, one autonomous car object, and based on the object value we are printing the message here. Okay, so that's it. Okay, so hope you can understand. So thanks for watching this video, and if you like my videos, you can share with your friends, and also you can subscribe my channel, and in the description box you can see the channel link is there, so you can go there and watch the relevant videos. Okay, in my channel I am basically describing about the core Java, advanced Java, and web design related topics. So you can, and after subscribing my channel, you can click on the bell icon so that once I upload the next video, you will get the notification. Thanks for watching.